Well, the weekend's over. We're back at it here on this 30th day of January, 2023. This is Wake Up in Wenatchee Valley. I am Dan Kuntz, and it is cold. Clear skies, gorgeous morning, beautiful sunrise is almost upon us. But it ain't real warm. It's 12 degrees outside of our studios. This looks to be the coldest day of this cold period. We're talking about a gradual warming trend, and I mean gradual warming trend. It's going to take its sweet time, but little by little. Each day of the week will be a couple of degrees warmer than the day before. We'll be back up to near normal by the time we get to the upcoming weekend as we welcome February, and maybe a little bit of snow over the weekend as well. It's cold, 12 degrees. Leading the way, though, in our area, at least in north central Washington, for cold temperatures is OMAC. OMAC is at 0 degrees, so they have no degrees in OMAC. We'll take a look up at Okanagan County with our PTZ cameras in just a little bit. But your forecast, pretty gray outside of today. We have a beautiful morning, but the clouds are going to start creeping in as the day progresses. So if you want one more blast of vitamin D, today is the day before the clouds return. News, yes, sports. We now know the matchup for Super Bowl 57 in Glendale, Arizona in a couple of Sundays on the 12th of February. It'll be the Eagles and the Chiefs. We'll talk about that. We'd show you highlights of the championship games, but the NFL charges for those because apparently they need the money. So we can't show you highlights without paying for them. And, well, we're not going to do that. We will have some Kraken highlights there in first place in the Pacific Division. Head into the All-Star break. We like that. More fun stuff with our Today in History and some celebrity birthdays. And, well, McNaughty has got an opinion, so that'll end up not so maybe fun. Anyway, and February, which is 2 days away, is Heart Health Month. And we had a great conversation with a cardiologist at Confluence Health. Her name is Dr. Kim Skelding. She knows her stuff. She's going to talk about the old ticker, specifically about women and their heart health, because heart disease is still the number one killer of adult women in this country. We'll see if we can do something about that with Dr. Skelding in the back half of the program. Well, let's get going. Let's take our tour. We should have some spectacular footage this morning. Again, no clouds out there. A little slate gray, but sun's not quite creeping up over the East Wenatchee Bench as we look out over the valley. Saturday's high was 38. Yesterday's high was 27. And today's high is going to be even colder than that before we gradually begin to warm up. But check this out. Sunrise this morning, 7:29. Sunset tonight, 4:59. That gives us exactly 9.5 hours of daylight. And starting tomorrow, sunset will be at 5:01. Good morning to the valley. Camera 2 is going to take us up to Kashmir. Oh, yep. Is that the Kashmir camera? Good morning to Kashmir. How you doing? It's good to see you. The enchantments are looking good. Kashmir. Is it me or they have more snow in Kashmir? You can see down there at the community park at the very bottom of your screen right along the Wenatchee River. It looks like all the grass is still covered in snow there. I don't know if they actually have more snow or because most of the large grass fields that I've seen in the valley anyway are pretty devoid of snow. Anyway, that's a stunningly beautiful view there. And you can just see the very top of the enchantment starting to get kissed by that daylight. Let's check out monitor. We'll stay in the upper valley. That is the monitor camera. Not quite light enough for that thing to switch from black and white to color. You can see the morning commute. Everybody heading east into the Wenatchee Valley to do whatever it is that they have to do on this Monday. Yeah, lots of headlights heading into Wenatchee, not too many taillights heading out. That's nature. And finally, check this out. Billy Goat checks in with a stunning view there. You can see a little bit of the Columbia River. We have that camera pointed almost directly due east, right at the sunrise, maybe a little southeast of that. Just gorgeous. And of course, that area up in the Okanagan Valley, they're still very much covered in snow. They've had more snow than we had down there, and the temperatures are colder in the Okanagan Valley, which is why they are still covered pretty much everywhere with snow up there. No snow in the forecast, but it's going to be a little on the cool side. We have this one slide to show for you from the National Weather Service. Again, very cold today. We're not going to get real warm at all. We'll be well below freezing, as a matter of fact. Then later on today, the clouds will be thickening up. There is a chance of precipitation on Friday and Saturday on the valley floors. A little bit of light snow off and on, hit and miss. No major snow event for the mountain passes. That's Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. They could get a little snow here and there. Not really too bad. We're going to avoid the snow altogether. We are going to be high and dry all week. There's no precipitation at all in the forecast till we get to the weekend. In fact, from Apple Valley Honda, proud to sponsor the weather for. I'm assuming they're proud to sponsor it. Maybe if the weather's bad, they don't want to sponsor it for the National Weather Service. Sunshine for the most part. Again, late in the afternoon, mid to late afternoon, the clouds will begin to creep in. And we'll get up to about 24 degrees, 17 for the overnight low tonight. So it's going to be a little bit warmer because we're going to have cloud cover. And then cloudy, gray, and cold on Tuesday. Cloudy, gray, and cold on Wednesday. Cloudy, gray, and cold on Thursday. Sing along if you want. Back up to warmer than normal temperatures, but not much. By Friday night, we're talking about a slight chance of rain and snow with a high of Friday of 41 and overnight low of 31. Into the weekend, Saturday, snow level is going to be at 2,400 feet. Don't think we're going to get any. Snow level is going to be right around 24 to 2,500 feet right into the weekend. So some locations may get some light snow over the weekend. If we get anything at all as the temperatures warm up, it'll be in the form of rain. It is, after all, late January, early February. Fairly typical. 6 minutes after the hour, grab your coffee, come right back. I got the news for you. You're watching a Monday edition of Wake Up Wenatchee Valley on the NCW Live channel.
With all the variety on SureStream TV from Localtel, there's always something to watch. But what if you hit the couch in the middle of all the shows? That's a perfect time to use the features Catch Up or Restart. Catch up on shows from up to 3 days ago, or restart your show from the beginning. Go to your guide and select the show to restart. Then play, pause, rewind on your schedule. Don't forget, SureStream TV from Localtel lets you decide when shows begin.
Bring the whole family up to Stormy Mountain Brewing and Local Public House in historic downtown Chelan. Applewood smoked brisket, street-style tacos, and our award-winning barbecue rubs and sauces. Our meals pair perfectly with our exciting lineup of craft ales, made right here in Chelan. We've got room for big groups, or give us a call for catering. So grab the kids and check out the fun at Stormy Mountain Brewing and Local Public House, located in the heart of Chelan.
Seven and a half minutes after the hour, it is beautiful, clear skies, but it's cold. It's 12 degrees outside of our studios. Mid-20s today, a little bit warmer on Tuesday, a little bit warmer, just incrementally day by day. If you want sunshine, today is the day because it's going to be taking the rest of the week off. The Wenatchee City Council heard from planners on Thursday night on the remodeling of the Convention Center. In downtown Wenatchee, managers of the convention center say, hey, it needs a facelift. It needs more versatile interior spaces for meetings, parties, and other events. The cost estimate hovers around $12 million. And for that, they're going to add about 13,000 more square feet of usable space. Consultants say they'll continue to refine the design, and they're looking at two different options over the next few months.
So on the upper floor, this is at the Wenatchee Avenue level. This shows the addition with the pre-function space, the breakout space that's around 4,200 square feet. You'll notice that we worked a lot with where an elevator would go so that we can really maximize its use and its ability to work for both the convention center as well as the performing arts center. Currently, the performing arts center has to go pretty deep within the space to utilize the elevator. So this position really allows them to circulate up and down on either side of the space. So this kind of shows the overall view. This is an aerial view from Wenatchee Avenue, showing how the plaza is impacted. Really, the strength that it brings that kind of touches on one of the weaknesses found in the study is really being able to create a visibility to Wenatchee Avenue from Wenatchee Avenue, bringing a presence within the urban, you know, downtown district.
I've been lucky enough to go to a lot of events at the convention center, especially with what my wife Jenny does, and I can totally see how the reconfiguring of the rooms down there would make a big difference. So I'm for moving forward.
If this is something we do, maybe in a year or two from now, we need a committee to see what the future is for the following 10 years. And I think we lack that thinking or thought process to look at that future.
I appreciate the architects taking this assessment that is semi-old and addressing every single issue and coming up with a plan that satisfies all of those things. And if it wasn't satisfying those things, then I wouldn't support it. But it is answering those questions, satisfying the needs that we have been talking about for a long time. And we have the money and the plan to move forward. So I'm in full support of option A and B.
The East Wenatchee Water District is adding a small addition to its system thanks to a partnership with the Douglas County PUD's hydrogen project. The PUD installed an extended main line at the Baker Flats site to pipe water to the hydrogen facility in case of fire. Last week, the PUD board voted to transfer ownership of that new infrastructure to the water district and provide a two-year bond to pay for its maintenance. The piping is valued at about $61,000. The water district doesn't have to pay anything. The maintenance bond will cover about a tenth of that value. The Bombardier Q400 prop airplane made its final flight on Thursday at Pangbourne Memorial Airport. Alaska Airlines, of course, announced in March that it planned to shift regional flights to the Embraer 175 twin jet. And unlike the Q400, the E-175 offers first class and business class seating. The Q400 previously flew out of Pangbourne and Pullman, Walla Walla, and Yakima four times a day at the time. At the time of the E-175 transition announcement, Alaska operated 32 turboprop Q400 aircraft. Governor Inslee is coming to town, coming to the Wenatchee Valley, planning to visit anyway. This week, the governor's office confirmed he will be coming to the Wenatchee Valley, but details of the visit, including the date and the destination, hasn't been disclosed yet. Local officials said the governor is likely to tour social service agencies in the valley. The governor's office said the full itinerary will be firmed up today and it'll be shared with local media. And finally, Wenatchee teacher Hugo Zavala testified in favor of House Bill 1228. He did that in front of the House Education Committee last week. The bill aims to build a multilingual and multiliterate Washington state through dual and tribal language education. In his testimony, Zavala, who is a fourth grade dual language teacher at Lewis and Clark Elementary, describes the importance of multilingualism.
As our state and country become more diverse and more globally interdependent, there's a growing need for all of our students to become multilingual and multicultural. We have solutions that are based on research, equity, and cultural reality. Research shows that multilingualism has lifelong cognitive, academic, social, cultural, and economic benefits. Dual language programs have also been shown to have most impact on supporting our multilingual learners by capitalizing on student strengths while being responsive to the needs of developing bilingual and bicultural students. Instilling in them, like myself, the importance of their biliteracy journey. Dual language is a long-term investment, and my children, my students, and myself are living testaments of the success of Washington State bilingual education. For these reasons, we need to expand access to dual language immersion opportunities, support, recruit, and retain dual language teachers like myself, and provide outreach so we can drastically close learning gaps for our multilingual learners. Simultaneously, bringing native English speakers up to par with the rest of the world by having them become multicultural and multilingual. But more importantly, we as a state and as a nation need to celebrate the power and the opportunities provided by our multilingual, multicultural, global learners like myself.
Zavala was named the 2023 Regional Teacher of the Year by the North Central Educational Services District. And he was selected as the Association of Two-Way and Dual Language Education Teacher of the Year in 2022. You're in the loop of what's happening on this Monday, January 30th. And the whole crew will be gathering together in the bullpen to put together a newscast for you at 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock, and 10 o'clock. It's a good group. Trust me, I know. I work with them. And with a preview of the Monday Night News, the anchor, Grant Olson.
Good morning, Dan. Coming up tonight on the NCW Life Evening News, we will bring you our exclusive interview with Washington State Attorney General Bob Ferguson. Unseasonably cold Arctic air is upon us. When will we see some relief? I'll let you know in your complete North Central Washington weather forecast. And in sports, Eric Granstrom has a wrap on all the area high school, college, and pro sports from over the weekend. That and all the day's news stories coming your way tonight at 5, 6, and 10 on the NCW Life Evening News. We hope to see you then. Dan?
Thank you, Grant. And if you have a news tip, by golly, by gum, make it happen. Let us know about it. go to our Facebook page, drop us a note on the Messenger app. You can connect with us via our website. Or maybe the best thing to do is just simply email us, news@ncwlife.com. When we come back, the Eagles and the Chiefs, the last two standing. We'll talk about the upcoming Super Bowl matchup, what happened over the world over the weekend in prep sports, and a whole bunch more. A lot of sports in just 1 minute. You're watching Wake Up in Wenatchee Valley on the NCW Life channel.
I chose a career at Confluence South because I wanted to help people, and I knew there would be opportunities for growth. I started as a medical assistant, but quickly advanced in my career. I received 5 promotions in only 7 years, 3 of those in management roles. Most organizations don't offer that type of growth. Now, as a career pathway coordinator, I let everyone know. Come join Confluence South. Come grow with us.
When Mike leaves town, it's a little scary. You never know who might be outside. But we feel safer inside, knowing our home is being monitored by a local company. I can check our alarm from just about anywhere. So when we get home, I know it's safe.
Protect your family and save money with a local company. Switch your current security monitoring to Guardian Services from Localtel. Call Guardian Security from Localtel now or visit localtel.net to learn more.
Seventeen minutes after the hour, down to just 2. But the NFC Championship game was not. The AFC Championship was yesterday. That was worth watching. Kansas City connecting on a 45-yard field goal with 3 seconds left in regulation to put the Chiefs into Super Bowl LVII, sometimes called Super Bowl 57. They'll beat Philadelphia in Glendale, Arizona on February 12th. The Eagles crushing San Francisco 31-7. At Arrowhead, with the game tied at 20, time running out, Patrick Mahomes scrambling on his bad ankle to set up what would have been a 55-yard field goal at least. But as you probably saw, one of the Bengals' defensive ends hit Mahomes out of bounds. That moved Kansas City 15 yards closer to the goalposts, and Harrison Butker's put it through the upright. The NFC Championship, by the way, saw San Francisco rookie quarterback Brock Purdy go down with an elbow injury. It was all Eagles after that. Philadelphia put up 148 yards and 4 rushing touchdowns to win going away. So we're ready to go. Super Bowl 57, Sunday, February 12th, 3:30 on Fox. The Seattle Kraken head into the All-Star break in NHL play 1 point ahead of Vegas in the Pacific Division. They beat Columbus on Saturday, 3-1. Saturday's win came a night after Seattle lost to Calgary on home ice 5-2. Morgan Geeky got the scoring goaling, and then the Kraken never looked back.
Get Geeky out here with Burakovsky and Tanev, but again, that line.
Morgan Geeky finds the magic. His first goal in 30 games. That has to feel great for 67. And the Kraken are off and running. McCann, Eberle, out in front. Merzlikin shuts the door. Dunn and McCann jamming. Eberle out in front. There's Wenberg. There's a goal. Former team through center, pickpocketing move by Roslovic. He's got it to the slot. Johnson a shot. He scores. Kent Johnson, the Canadian Olympian, picked up by Tolvanen. A shot. He scores. Hey, hey! What do you say, Ellie Tolvanen? 3-1, Seattle. 5 seconds. Yanni Gord powers out. Looks at the net, carries in, off the goalpost, but at the break, the Seattle Kraken are in first place in the Pacific Division.
Yeah, they are. Coach Dave Haxtell, after the game, said it was a great way to end the first half of the season, a victory at home in front of a big crowd.
You know, the first half of this hockey game, the start was excellent, what we wanted. You know, a little bit typical. You know, you get into these games and the other, you know, the other team's goaltender is, you know, is on it and playing really well. You know, we couldn't stretch the lead, and then, you know, it's going to be, you know, it's going to be a horse race down the stretch, and that's exactly what it was. But, you know, it's a real good win for our team. It's a really good response coming off of last night. It's a great way to finish off the month of January for our team.
Kraken is off now until February 7th. It is the All-Star break for the NHL. The Wenatchee Wild managed to go 1-1 with Vernon over the weekend at the Town Toyota Center. Despite a couple of goals in the second period from Garrett Sosnowski, the visitors came out on top Friday night, 4-2. But Wenatchee came back the next night with the help of Ian Somoza's hat trick. They won 4-1 in front of a big crowd at the Town Toyota Center.
Got a little bit of the post, I think, with Milburn as well. Turned over, and Somoza on the move. Can he get loose? Streaking in. One of the goalie backhand forehand. Save, rebound, he scores! Somoza picks up his own rebound with a little bit of an angle on Roanecourt. And the Wenatchee Wild strike first. It's 1-0. The puck, Somoza gains it. Surrounded by Vipers, trying to beat at least three here, maybe four. Comes over the blue line, hands it off right point for Sidlowski. Dukes it around a defender, back to Somoza, backhand chance, he scores! Ian Somoza, have mercy! 2-0, Wenatchee! The goal 4 minutes in, and had the empty netter last night as well. Caraming, a shot from the right point, McMaster, hit the referee, pass out front, mid-slot Horn, sends home the one-timer, and it's 2-1. The lead drops back to a single goal for the Wild. Wild moving left to right, breaking free, Somoza, maybe 2-on-1. Somoza, left wing, wrist shot, save in, jousted in, he scores! It is Somoza, it is time to throw the hat at Town Toyota Center! Back out to Barr, this one cleared out, trying to chase it down is Valdez, and he won't have much ground to cover if he gets there first. Valdez, top half, he scores! Empty netter, 4-1. Come all the way out in front of the penalty box, it's down to 5 seconds. We'll let the crowd take you the rest of the way.
Austin Drudy with the call on the Wenatchee Wild Hockey Network, and it was good to have Uncle Ernie back, the longtime public address announcer, returned on Saturday to the Town Toyota Center. By the way, Wenatchee travels to Merritt Friday and Salmon Arm Saturday. They'll be back home in a couple of weeks. To the men's college basketball scoreboard from Saturday from our friends at Les Schwab, Eastern Washington edged Weber State, 6th-ranked Arizona, no trouble, beating Washington and Seattle, and 14th-ranked Gonzaga held off Portland. Washington State bounced back from a loss Thursday. They beat Arizona State over the weekend, 75-58 in Pullman.
Justin Powell, line drive three. 6 threes for Powell at season high 20. On the drive, TJ Bamba draws a foul and one.
Way to get some wins and get back onto that bubble.
14 threes, Andrei Yakimovsky from outside the arc. And that falls off, and the final, 75-58, Washington State.
Coach Kyle Smith said he was a little worried about an emotional letdown after their narrow loss to Arizona on Thursday night, but it turns out that didn't happen.
You know, a great win, any league win is. Really thought we played well this week. Played hard Thursday. I didn't necessarily play as well execution-wise, but boy, Arizona's a good team, and we're a little concerned going in this game. I thought we were, a little emotionally drained going in because really didn't have a day off from anything. We got in late Sunday night. Took Monday off from practice, but guys went to class. We put a lot into that game Thursday night, and it was a late game, and then we had to come back, and I was a little concerned at shoot around, but our guys did a really good job of, just played, it's just tough. We had some guys that didn't play as well as they could, but we played hard, played like a team, and had a good, really good win for us.
That was the men's highlights. To the ladies we go. We'll start with Friday. Washington State edged Arizona State. The Huskies losing to 19th-ranked Arizona. Weber State nipping Eastern Washington on Saturday, and 17th-ranked Gonzaga easy over Pepperdine. The Cougar women pulled off the upset Saturday. They beat 19th-ranked Arizona, 70-59. Washington also a winner yesterday. They beat Arizona State, 55-53. Congratulations to the Wenatchee High School girls bowling team. Yet another Big Nine district title. They won it Friday at Eastmont Lanes. 3,789 points. Eastmont runner-up. 3,582 points, and the Wildcats had the medalist, Reese Kautzman, with the 599 series. Wenatchee Charlene Campbell second, teammate Ava Porter third. The ladies will head for Tukwila this week for the state tournament Wednesday, through Saturday. To the Les Schwab Prep basketball scoreboard, we'll start with the ladies. For the big schools on Friday, Wenatchee scored its most points of the season, but they still lost to Eastmont. Sunnyside edged Moses Lake and Ellensburg eased by Ephrata. On Saturday, Othello knocked off Ephrata. Sunnyside 22 better than Eastmont. Davis easily beat Wenatchee, and Moses Lake upended Ike. In boys' play Friday, Eastmont came back in a seesaw battle with the Panthers to win 67-62. Sunnyside beat up Moses Lake 67-51. Ephrata picked up the first of its two wins over the weekend. They beat Ellensburg, and then the Tigers returned home Saturday and beat Othello. Eastmont won at Sunnyside on Saturday. Davis whipped Wenatchee, and Moses Lake won by 5 over Ike. For the smaller schools on Friday, Chelan edged Royal. Omak peppered Pateras. Brewster no trouble with Orville. Lake Roosevelt rolled over Liberty Bell. Antioch beating Riverside Christian. Moses Lake Christian shut down Soap Lake. Waterville Mansfield edged Wilbur Creston. And Columbia Adventist beat Cascade Christian in Bellingham 36-24. On the boys' side Friday, Omak clobbered Cascade. Chelan dumped Royal. Lake Roosevelt rang Liberty Bell. Brewster battered Orville. Antioch topped Riverside Christian. Moses Lake Christian winners, as was Wilbur Creston, beating Waterville Mansfield. And Upper Columbia beat Cascade Christian over at Western Washington University. Getting all this is going to be a test later on. Turning to girls' play on Saturday, Antioch over Cascade, Cashmere surprising Okanagan. Lakeside at a 9 mile falls, had no trouble with Quincy. Curlew beat Oroville. The boys' scores on Saturday, Okanagan edged Cashmere. Lakeside 9 mile falls, got by Quincy. Antioch top Thorpe. Cascade Christian finished its visit to Western Washington with a victory over Milo Adventist. And we will be right back at Eastmont High School on Saturday. Wildcats set to host Eisenhower. The girls game at 4:45, the boys at 6:30 on TV and on Facebook. Eric and Grant with the call. And those are just some of the games that people are playing on this 30th day of January. Happy National Bubble Wrap Day today. Bubble Wrap Appreciation Day today. Everybody loves when, you know, you get a package and it's wrapped in bubble wrap. What's the first thing you do? Pop, 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 pop. Now, of course, they don't really... Bubble wrap is falling out. You don't really see much of it anymore. Bubble wrap goes back to 1957. A couple of inventors by the name of Alfred Fielding and Mark Chavinus. What they were trying to do was make three-dimensional wallpaper. That's where the bubble wrap came from. Nobody wanted to buy and install three-dimensional wallpaper, but then they discovered, hey, this can cushion items when you ship them. And so they patented the term bubble wrap in 1960 and started the Sealed Air Corporation, which is still in existence. And then they got real lucky. Right after they patented bubble wrap and started the Sealed Air Corporation, IBM called and said, we have these great big, huge computers, the UBM 1401, and they're very expensive and very heavy, and we have to ship them in crates. Can we use your bubble wrap? And they said, sure. Good way to get your money going there. In 2015, the Sealed Air Corporation invented what's called eye bubble wrap. That's uninflated bubble wrap, and that's what everybody sees now. You see that now. You can't pop it. But it's deflated, and then they inflate it to fit around the package. So it saves a lot of money, and bubble wrap itself is slowly fading away. I was going to pop some bubble wrap on the air today. I forgot to bring some in 28 minutes after the hour. Today in history, a friendly reminder, for about 10 years there, back in the 1600s, England got rid of the monarchy. Thanks to Oliver Cromwell, who said, Charles I has got to go. Charles I went. They executed him. They executed him. Oliver Cromwell ran the British Empire for about 10 years, and then they killed him. They executed him. They went back to the monarchy. So it was on this date that Oliver Cromwell, the Lord Protector of the Commonwealth of England, is executed. He'd be dead 2 years. No, that's what they did back then. They actually executed him 2 years earlier. They dug him up and they ritually executed him again. Apparently they did things back like that back in those days, 262 years ago today. We often talk about the hubris of man, the Titanic unsinkable. Well, it hit an iceberg and sank. But they learned their lesson. 64 years ago today, on this date, 1959, after 49 years after the Titanic struck an iceberg on its maiden voyage in the North Atlantic and sunk, they finally came out with the unsinkable ship, the HMS Hans Hedtoft. The Hans Hedtoft can't sink. And on its maiden voyage, on this date, 1959, Hans Hedtoft unsinkable hand sent off, strikes an iceberg in the North Atlantic on its maiden voyage and sinks. If it can float, it can sink. Everybody on board died. That was on this date 64 years ago today. 54th anniversary of the Beatles' last public performance. During the Let It Be Get Back sessions, it was up to the roof they go on a bitterly cold Monday. They went to the rooftop of their Apple Records headquarters. Nobody could see them except for the people in the office towers and the people who climbed up on the roofs and on the fire escapes that surrounded the roof of the Apple building. They set up a makeshift stage. They played for 42 minutes, blasting rock and roll all over downtown London until the cops came and told them to shut it up. They played for about 42 minutes during the lunch hour. You could hear them, just couldn't see them. The famous Beatles rooftop concert 54 years ago today. And of course, we're doing Super Bowl XVII. Super Bowl 17, Washington defeats Miami 27-12 in Pasadena. This was the 1982 season 40 years ago. And of course, that was the strike year. They only played nine regular season games that year. They did a completely different playoff format than you're used to. The MVP of Super Bowl 17, John Riggins, totaled 181 yards from scrimmage. The Miami Dolphins, as a team, got 176 yards from the line of scrimmage. John Riggins alone outgained the entire Miami offense. Perhaps the most interesting thing of this game was the coin toss. The captain of the Dolphins called tails. The referee flipped it. It landed tails. And the referee said, it landed heads. Washington, you win the coin toss. And the line judge came in and said, no, Jerry. He called tails. And it's tails, Jerry. Oh, it is tails. Sorry. That was about the highlight of that. Washington wins their very first Super Bowl. Super Bowl XXVIII. Super Bowl 28. Cowboys defeat the Bills in Atlanta. Another blowout. Of course, this is the first and only time that the same two teams met in consecutive Super Bowls. Dallas had kicked Buffalo's butt the year before. Of course, the Bills now became, after this game, the only team to play in and lose four consecutive Super Bowls. And finally, on this date in 2000, 23 years ago today, Super Bowl 34, XXXIV, one of the great games of the Super Bowl history, went right down to the last play, the famous tackle at the one-yard line. The St. Louis Rams beat the Titans 23-16 at the Georgia Dome in Atlanta. This is the most recent Super Bowl in which neither team had won a Super Bowl before. The tackle at the very last play. It was a great game. I remember watching it, playing cards with my buddies. This was the first Super Bowl, by the way, to be broadcast in high-definition television, even though I didn't have it. 32 minutes after the hour, birthdays, one of the big three. George Washington, who essentially invented the presidency. The presidency was invented for him, and he invented the office. And then you have Abraham Lincoln, who saved the Union. And then you have FDR, who changed the presidency and the federal government to what we know today. Franklin Delano Roosevelt, the 32nd president of the United States. All historians agree that he is one of the giants of the 20th century, one of the top three presidents this country has ever produced, alongside George Washington and Abraham Lincoln, FDR, born in the state in 1882. Gene Hackman, he's been completely retired now for 20 years. Hasn't made a movie for 20 years. He's living life. Life's good. I don't need to work no more. Gene Hackman is 93. Best actor for The French Connection. Best supporting actor, playing this sadistic sheriff in Unforgiven. He won the best supporting actor for that. Bonnie and Clyde, The Beside Adventure. Oh, I don't know. Hoosiers, Mississippi Burning, The Conversation. The great Gene Hackman is 93 years old today. And when you add up all the work that Phil Collins did in the 1980s, his solo albums, his work with Genesis, and his duets with other artists, Phil Collins, who is 72 years old today, was the most successful recording artist of the 1980s. Think about it. He was everywhere in the 80s. Happy 72nd birthday to Phil Collins. Going to take a break. Mike McNaughty has got an opinion. And then, as we kick off Heart Health Month for the month of February, we're going to talk to our friends at Confluence Health. It's a cardiologist. She's good. Dr. Kim Skelding knows her stuff. Don't take my word for it. You're going to get to meet her when we come back. You're watching Wake Up in Anchie Valley on the NCW Live channel.
Hi. I believe we've been coming to Abby's for 56 years, isn't it?
Yes, yeah. 56 years.
Remembering all the events as a family and a community that we spent at Abby's.
Excellent and delicious food at an affordable price. We're delighted that we live close enough to be able to be a frequent customer.
And we are.
And we are. In fact, we've got orders to bring home a giant pizza when we leave here tonight.
1989, I moved here in July. My dad farmed, my brother's still on the family farm. I worked for a dealer in Lewiston, Idaho. I was his general sales manager. My boss goes, I got a guy that may be ready for a store. We made one trip here, and that's how I ended up here. I'd never been here in my life, and I had no friends here. I have nothing, you know. I do now. I have a lot of friends here. I mean, this is my home. I love living here.
If you could live anywhere, where would it be? What would it be like? With today's home values, this is the perfect time to sell and make those dreams real. When you work with a world-class agent at Coldwell Banker, you benefit from trusted guidance and a revolutionary seller's assurance program to make your home sale more rewarding than ever. So it really is true. Your dreams don't have to be just dreams.
When you call Dix Heating and Air Conditioning, you're calling on 35-plus years of experience in the Wenatchee Valley. Spending extra time in your home, you may have discovered an unwanted aroma. Stinky feet, pets, who knows what. Call Dix today about installing their Trane CleanFX electronic air cleaner or a Rheem Halo ultraviolet air purifier. Either way, the air quality in your home will be improved. Proudly servicing all of North Central Washington, call 884-6444 today.
This is Mike Mad Dog Magnotti, and everybody is entitled to my opinion. Now, I do some adoption work. I think you know that. And now and then, mostly what I do is what we call family adoption, in which a step-parent, usually a guy, frankly, is stepping up to adopt his wife's children. Well, when this type of adoption occurs, the adoption petitioner, like I said, usually the dad, is accepting all legal and social and economic responsibility to those children who, although they aren't his biological kids, have the same rights and relationship the new dad has to any biological children that might be in the relationship. To make this point, I always tell the prospective adopted parent, yes, you know, you now have the authority to sign the child's field trip permission slips, but they also become your heir and they're going to inherit your stuff. Now, happily, most of these prospective parents just are very happy and eager to accept all this responsibility. And then I tell them there's no act of love more important than what they're doing to provide a secure parent for a child. And I admire the hell out of them for it. It's great, adoption. And this is Mike Mad Dog Magnotti, and that's my opinion.
Working with August Edge Real Estate, both sellers and buyers feel confident knowing they are in the hands of award-winning professionals. August Edge offers a 2% listing commission, which includes above-standard service and technology.
We offer high-tech 3D imagery, drone photos, local North Central Washington TV ads, and impressive smart flyer installed at your listing. The August Edge website also hosts your home with an interactive featured listing page.
August Edge is professional, personable, and preferable.
This could be the view out of your office window.
North Central Washington is probably one of the most beautiful places to live, and you get to experience it all as a transit operator.
Link Transit coach operators enjoy full family benefits, paid CDL training, a state-of-the-art fleet, and the satisfaction of being part of a progressive, community-minded team.
We have a lot of fun with each other. I mean, it's a good group of people. We're all kind of like a family.
If you like this view, Link has a seat for you. The next operator training starts soon. Apply today at linktransit.com.
Come on, I'm a certified technician. I was trained to take good care of you.
Nein, I've only been to the dealer.
I've been coming here for years. These guys are great.
Look around. The BMW, the Jag, the Volvo, they're all waiting for regular service. Well, the BMW has a little computer issue, but that's nothing we can't handle. Come on in.
From regular maintenance to computer troubleshooting, trust the Global Car Care technicians with your import, diesel-powered, or domestic vehicle. Global Car Care, they speak your car's language.
Dankeschön.
At
Local Myth Pizza, we believe in real food, freshly prepared with only premium ingredients. Our cheeses are imported from Italy. Our sauces, dressings, and even our sausages are made in-house fresh daily. Featuring Northwest craft beers and 30 Chelan Valley wines and ciders. Family fun and amazing food. Eat local, drink local, and be local at Local Myth Pizza.
Come see why Sunset Magazine says you can't beat Local Myth Pizza.
Welcome back to the program. February is Heart Health Month. It should be all months considered. And it's been way too long since our friends at Confluence Health has paid us a visit. They are back. We're going to introduce you to Kimberly Skelding, MD, medical doctor. And she knows what she's talking about because she works in the cardiology department at Central Washington Hospital and Confluence Health. Thanks for taking time out of your busy day.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, I appreciate it. Sobering statistic number one, there will be others. Heart disease is the leading cause of death among women in this country. One out of every five female deaths attributable to heart disease, which is the first thing that makes you go, what? What is that? Is that, well, first of all, it's an alarming number. Did it used to be one in 10? What's going on?
Well, I certainly think it's gotten more of a problem over the last several years, diet, lifestyle, just choices that we make. But I think people are really shocked when they hear that, and also shocked to know that women are more likely to die of heart disease than all types of cancers combined, which is really scary.
Is it because they don't know they have problems with the ticker, or they do and they ignore it, or is it just attributable to gender?
A little bit of all those things. Certainly there are risk factors that we don't really know we have. You know, you don't have necessarily a symptom with high cholesterol. Some people don't even have symptoms with high blood pressure. And so all of these things are going on in the background. And unless you're seeing your family doctor every year and having them checked and having your risk factors looked at, you don't know. And so all of a sudden you've had a heart attack or had a stroke, and if you hadn't been to the doctor, you might not know of these whole laundry list of risk factors.
And that's one of the things we want to eliminate. We want to eliminate to the point where you have a heart attack or a stroke. We want to back away from that. Well, let's talk about this get this going, Doc, before we go into the deeper thing of it. When it comes to the heart, how do you know something might not be working quite right in the world of cardiovascular? I'm not talking about a heart attack symptoms. We'll talk about that. I'm talking about just general symptoms that something might not be right for the ticker. And I'll give you an example. A friend of mine, mother just had open heart surgery, and her number one symptom was just fatigue. She just had no get up and go. It didn't take her very long for her to become exhausted. Outside of that, she didn't feel bad. She just tired real easily. What are some things we need to look for?
Well, I think it's important to, be active. So if you are regularly active and you find that you can't do as much as you were able to do, you can't walk as much, you can't hike as much, you can't bike as much, you just can't do your household chores as much. If there's a big change in your activity level, being able to just sort of hit a brick wall, that's a time to get checked. Because it could be that you have fatigue, it could be shortness of breath, it could be chest pain, it could be a lot of different symptoms, but I think the biggest piece is looking for a change in your functional capacity.
And as far as symptoms from a heart attack, I think most people know the general symptoms to look for. Fatigue is one of them. Chest pains, pain in your neck and your shoulders, specifically I think the left arm or left shoulder is the one that really jumps out at you. Nausea, all of those things. That's across the board, I think probably for both sexes, but for females, is there different symptoms to look for that I got some serious problems that need to be looked at right now?
Well, one of the misnomers, or one of the things that we think that is a myth, is that women don't have chest pain. Well, men and women both have chest pain with their heart attacks. The problem is that women have usually about three other symptoms with it. You mentioned a lot of them, which is really important. Anxiety, fatigue, shortness of breath, sweatiness, all of those things can be a symptom. And because they're sort of muddied, it's not just the chest pain, it's all these other things, women are often underdiagnosed.
So it could be, I'll give an angina for an example. Mm-hmm. You have an angina attack, but it's the only thing that is, you don't have anything else that goes with it. You don't have nausea or pain mm-hmm. in the shoulder or whatever. That's one thing. Is it a combination of different kinds of things that says I'm having a heart attack then, as opposed to just you just have one really serious discomfort but not the other symptoms?
It could be a little bit of anything.
Okay.
I think the key to trying to figure it out is if it come on with exertion, or does it not go away no matter what you do? So symptoms that come on with exertion go away with rest are generally heart related, and also symptoms that come on and continue to get worse despite anything we do would be the time to call 911 and get to the emergency room.
So you're in the cardiology department, which is that's a lot. I mean, that's a lot to, why did you become a heart doctor? I mean, you're a physician. You obviously, somewhere along the line, when you were a kid, saw the seed was planted. I think I wanted to be a physician and take care of people and help them through long and healthy lives. Give us a little bit about Dr. Skelton. What made you decide, when I grow up, I want to take care of this thing right here?
Well, so that's a long conversation.
I got nothing but time.
But, you know, in medical school, you like a lot of different things. And when I hit cardiology, I realized I liked two parts of it. I'm an interventional cardiologist, so I'm someone who treats heart attacks, puts stents in, fixes valves. And so I like the combination of doing procedures and the cerebral or the thought part of helping people with the risk factors. So it's sort of disparate. I really am into prevention, preventing people from having heart attacks, and also treating heart attacks.
Prevention is common sense. Don't drink, don't smoke, exercise, eat healthy. That's all pretty much a no-brainer. But you can certainly cut down on your risk factor by doing certain things, right?
Right. So getting enough sleep, getting at least 7 hours of sleep a night, trying to reduce the stress in your life, that can be hard. And also trying to have some connections with people. Loneliness is associated with heart disease. It's a big deal.
I never thought about that, loneliness being associated with heart mm-hmm. disease. I guess that makes sense if you think about it. You brought along a little goodie basket. Some of this stuff is going to be obvious. Some of this stuff is going to be maybe not so obvious. This is green. It's probably going to come out as gray. You brought me an avocado.
Yes.
Avocado and the heart are good for each other in what way?
Well, one of the things the reason why we brought an avocado is to remind you that not all fat is bad. And so there are good fats. Avocado is one of them. And fats are important to our whole body's working. And that would be a great way of getting your fat without doing trans fats, which are really unhealthy.
What other fruits and vegetables have good fat in them besides avocados?
Nuts.
Okay, yeah, well, here you go. Thank you, and I might add. You brought me some Blue Diamond whole natural, and natural, not covered in salt.
Yes.
Which is, of course, pretty common sense. Low salt popcorn.
Yes.
Low salt popcorn. So popcorn in and of itself is actually pretty good for you.
Yeah, it's not a bad snack.
It's the crap that we put on it that mm-hmm. That does it so good.
Correct.
And of course, good old fashioned banana. I'm a banana a day kind of guy, usually two. We associate bananas with potassium. So what
Correct.
Else are we talking about here?
They're just healthy to eat more fruits and vegetables, less meats and cheeses. If we fill up on the healthy things, we don't maybe sometimes have enough room for the bad stuff. So I always tell my patients to, when they look at their plate, half of it should be fruits and vegetables, a quarter should be their starches, and a quarter should be their protein.
So you've been, to end up on your desk, doc, I'm assuming your primary care physician, either during a regular checkup or just you've got something going on, refers the patient to you. Now I want you to go see Dr. Skelton, and then Dr. Skelton is going to take a look-see and say, you got some issues, but it's not too late. You can do some stuff. If you want to live till 90, let's start now. That's the kind of conversation you have with your patients?
Sure. So I meet two kinds of patients. One are patients just like you explained, people who don't have a heart problem yet, but have threatening heart problems, and those are the people that you can make a big impact with. We talk about cholesterol, blood pressure, stress, diabetes risk, all those things, and make sure that those things are more in alignment with the national guidelines. The second group of people that I meet quite frequently are people who have a heart problem, come in to me, need a stent, or have a heart attack. And those people, it's really important, it's a teachable moment, if you will, to tell people, you have an opportunity to never be back in this position again if we change some things around. And I always say, it's sort of funny, but it's true, I would love to put myself out of business.
Yeah, I mean, so would we, as a matter of fact. ain't going to happen. Yet to that note, in North Central Washington, the Wenatchee Valley, are we pretty good about that? What's our rate? I mean, you hear about the Deep South, where cardiovascular disease is a huge killer among females and males and African Americans and anybody. I mean, it's just mostly diet and life, exercise and stuff like that. How are we doing here in our area, North Central Washington? Do we keep specific tracks of how healthy our heart is in this area?
I think it's an important question. Uh-huh. I don't know that we're doing any better. I don't know that we're doing any worse. I will say that the population here in Wenatchee is a little more active, out there walking, biking, hiking, skiing, doing things up in the mountains. And that's really important to longevity, really important to lowering your heart risk. And living in a place like this where there's lots of opportunities for outdoor activities really can lower your risk.
I know it's still fairly new on the medical radar, but in your line of work, I'm assuming once COVID hit full bore a couple of years ago, it was like, okay, Kimberly, I'm talking to myself, what is this doing to the ticker? Does that pop immediately into mind when COVID started to rear its ugly head?
Sure. So we saw a lot of people come in with heart attacks during COVID because COVID makes your heart a little thicker, makes it more likely to clot. And so a lot of people had blood clots in their lungs, blood clots in their hearts, and then the long-term results. Not everybody recovers and feels just great. There's a number of people we call long haul patients who are short of breath and have chest pain and have all these symptoms that are just residual from COVID.
So if you had COVID and you've recovered, and maybe your family history, genetics speaking, has a history of coronary artery disease or cardiovascular disease, you should probably get checked, shouldn't you?
Yes.
Yeah.
Patients who have heart disease and get COVID, or at risk for heart disease and get COVID, get a lot sicker than healthy folks with COVID.
Well, let's talk about genetics real quick. What if I'm a 50-year-old female and mom lived 102 and dad dropped dead of a heart attack when he was 49? Is that, you still have a risk there? Something new?
Yeah, so the American Heart Association risks are looking for specifically for men and women who are younger when they have a heart attack. Dad, younger, 49.
Sure.
If you have a grandmother who was 83 and had a heart attack and that's the only person in your family, you're probably not having a genetic risk. Now, you might have risks for high blood pressure, high cholesterol, diabetes, those type of things, but not necessarily just a risk for heart attack.
This may sound like a stupid question. Why do people wait so long before, especially when it comes to the heart? Gee, the kidney's acting up. We can do something about this. You got a problem with this, that, or the other thing. The heart is the heart. Heart stops working, you're done. Why do we take the heart for granted? And I know it sounds like a stupid question, but it's true. We do. We take the heart for granted. We don't even think about it. It's just sitting there beating.
Right. So as long as the heart is doing its job, we take it for granted. And so a lot of these things are sort of in the background. The high blood pressure, the high cholesterol, and years and years and years of these things going on. People smoke, drink a little too much. All these things happen and we don't have any symptoms. And so you kind of ignore it. You're not thinking about it. You're not realizing the impact that these risk factors have on your heart until you have the event.
Friday the 3rd of February is Wear Red. I try to remember the actual, there's a name for it.
Yeah.
I know it's February 3rd, which makes it Friday. It's Wear Red for Heart Day. That's why she's wearing red and this is where I'm wearing red.
Yes.
So Wear Red, or we have this little pin here. This is my second pin because I got one last year as well. Talk about the significance of Go Red for Women.
So it's very important. The American Heart Association recognized several years ago that women were dying at a much higher rate from heart disease than their male counterparts. And it didn't really make sense. And what we started to do is we actually started to look into it and identify it. And part of it was women were not getting the care they needed early. They weren't coming in and explaining their symptoms appropriately. They weren't coming in and being taken seriously with their symptoms. They maybe weren't treated to the same guidelines. And so this campaign was really widespread for the patients, for the providers, for the caretakers, for everyone, to try to lessen that gap between the male and female patients.
Now that we hopefully have scared the bejesus out of my female viewers, and there's a lot of them, you know, the ladies love me. Let's end on a positive note. They're going to roll out, and I have the notes right here, Cooking with Confluence. They're going to get going on February 16th at the Eastmont Parks and Rec Community Center. It's basically how to cook healthy, tasteful food that won't make your ticker go nuts.
Yes.
Is that essentially it? Did I make it?
You did.
We'll throw the flyer up on screen to take care of it, but it's just amazing Yes, if your lifestyle doesn't lend itself to a healthy heart, it's almost never too late. You know, is that really the message that you really want to send out?
Yeah, never too late to get started. There's a gold standard, mm-hmm. and there's what is the worst standard.
Right.
And you want to try to get more over to the gold standard as you can. Not everybody can get there, but as close as possible.
And ironically enough, the vast majority, in fact, everybody I've ever known in my life who had a serious scare with their heart made that choice to say, okay, I'm going to go ahead and I think I want to stick around a little bit longer, not ready to exit my earthly vessel yet. So,
right.
Did we scare you? We don't mean to scare you. Dr. Skelding doesn't want to scare you, but she wants you to live a long time, which is why she does what she does. We're going to have more on throughout the month of February for February Heart Health Month with our friends at Confluence Health. It's nice to meet you, Dr. Skelding.
Thank you.
I hope you have a really boring month of February. I hope you're sitting at your computer at the office playing solitaire and taking three-hour lunches, although I have a feeling that's not the case. Thanks for joining me.
You're welcome.
We appreciate it. You're watching Wake Up in Wenatchee Valley. We'll be right back.
If you are looking for dependable car service and repair, visit the good guys at Quick Lube and Tune. They've been keeping cars and trucks in the Wenatchee Valley running smooth for 35 years. Quick Lube and Tune is your hometown shop for a 10-minute oil change, complete tune-ups, alignments, brakes, mufflers, air conditioning service, and more. Get more life out of your vehicle by bringing it to the local guys you can trust at Quick Lube and Tune on South Wenatchee Avenue.
I had a seizure in the middle of the night, and they rushed me to the hospital and decided to induce labor to try to get baby out. The outpouring of love and support I got from Confluence Health, my coworkers coming to the ICU to be with me. For me, it's the work family. It's just incredible to have support no matter what I'm going through in my personal life, my own health.
Spring is more than just a time to clean. It's your time to renew, recharge, and spend time with the people you love. At Merry Maids, our cleaning services go beyond the basic services and provide you with a comprehensive clean that will re-energize your home and enhance your life. From everyday routine cleaning or deep cleanings, Merry Maids professional team members can provide you with an unrivaled experience. Call Merry Maids to schedule your cleaning today.
And we are back. That spectacular shot up at Billy Goat reminds me to check in with you on the OMAC temperature. When this show began an hour ago, it was 0 degrees, as in none. No degrees in OMAC. But now it's almost an hour later, and OMAC has now got 1 degree. So the temperature has doubled up in OMAC. It's cooled down everywhere we've gone. It was 12 degrees when this show started. We're down to 10 here in the Wenatchee Valley, but we're not going to get much colder than that. In fact, this is going to be the coldest temperatures we're going to see during this cold snap stuff. Just as predicted, that Arctic air came in. It was a little late. It was supposed to come in Saturday afternoon. It didn't really come in until Saturday night. We went from 38 for the high on Saturday to 27 for the high yesterday. We're not even going to get that warm today. And then a little gradual up the ladder we go from Apple Valley Honda, the sponsor, and the National Weather Service, who actually does the forecasting, and they do it a lot better than I do. Lots of sunshine for most of the day today. As the day gets towards the end, towards sunset, around 5 o'clock, the clouds will be thickening up. We'll get up to about 24 degrees. Cloudy tonight, 17 for the overnight low. We'll be a little bit warmer tonight because we will have a little bit of a cloud cover to keep the warmth down. Not much, but it is what it is. Then we start going up the ladder. 28 with lots of clouds on Tuesday. High of 32 Wednesday. Lots of clouds. Thursday, lots of clouds and a high of 33. Friday, we finally warm up to where we should be, right around here, upper 30s to lower 40s, but maybe a little precipitation returns Friday and into the weekend. I don't think we're going to get much of anything here in the Wenatchee Valley. Yeah, I think we're going to miss out on the rain and the snow, but the passes are going to get some snow. Heads up there. And that's it for us. Have a great Tuesday. Bye-bye.